Hallo Leute, was geht? Hier ist Rasse von T-Brezel and I would like to show you my small shuttle in Business Information Technology because one of my subscribers has asked me that he would like to know more about Business Information Technology, so I thought why shouldn't I show you all guys my study plan and to give you also some great advices on how you also can pass. So let's start with the question, how does the shuttle look like? So usually the shuttle on my university is based on four learning areas. So the first learning area is business administration, the second one is informatics, the third one is called economics and social science framework, and the fourth one is like, it's gonna be your so-called key qualification, which is already given because it's like your first semester, and in this case it's gonna be English for IT. How does the business administration learning area is based on? And so it is based on two main models. So the first model is gonna be personal and organization. I think this model is really, really interesting, especially for the people who have the interest in the future, maybe to lead their own company, or maybe to have the interest to work, like let's say in a management position in a company. So they're gonna learn on how you can organize your employees, how you're gonna create like a positive and healthy and supportive work environment. And I think it's gonna be like really, really easy to pass. You just have to do it, like in my case, you just have to do like two scientific homeworks, maybe one presentation, and that's it. So I'm gonna say let's say 1.5 stars of 5. I think you're gonna pass it, it's not so difficult. So the second model of business administration is called financial accounting. This one was really, really interesting because you're gonna learn on how a balance sheet works. You're gonna learn how are you gonna define assets, what are liabilities, what is an equity, what is a financial equitation. You're also gonna learn like the crazy world of investment, because company who have like more expenses than revenue, they're somehow more interesting for the investor. So I'm gonna give it, like, since it was like a little bit more difficult, maybe let's say 2.5 stars of 5 that you're gonna pass it. And my recommendation is that if you never have worked with Excel sheets before, you should definitely do it. You're gonna find on YouTube thousands of videos about on how to use Excel sheets, because you're gonna need it on daily basis. And there is also like a great YouTube channel. I think the YouTube video is called Learn Financial Accounting in 1 Hour or somehow. It's like a small series of 4 videos, which are just each to 20 minutes. And those videos also helped me to pass this module, so I'm gonna definitely recommend it. You're gonna find the link in the video description. So let's go to the second learning area, and I think this one is like the most important, because it's like even the most difficult one, and this one is of course informatics. And informatics is gonna be like in your whole study, it's like half of your lessons are somehow related to informatics. They're gonna be like the most difficult, and like what I heard, the reason why most students don't pass the study is because of informatics. And so in your first semester, you're gonna learn about object-oriented programming. And if you never have heard about Java, and if you don't know the difference between Java and JavaScript, then I definitely gonna recommend you that you have to spend, before the study starts, do your basics with Java. And in a good case is on YouTube, also you're gonna find thousands of free lessons. You don't have usually pay money for it. Yeah, so to pass this learning area, you have to program a small game, and after you have programmed this game, you have also to write an exam, and this was really, really difficult. It wasn't difficult because of the programming itself, and the reason why it was difficult is because you have to understand on how logic works. If I have to give a rating, it's gonna be definitely 5 out of 5, because most of my I think in English you're gonna say classmates, they had like the biggest difficulties with it. So seriously, learn for it. Let's go to the third learning area. This is so-called legal, economic, and social. No, how does it go? Legal, economic, social science framework. And this one was really, really easy. I don't know, I think everybody has passed it. You just have to make like one presentation. You even can let's say you even can find your own topic to it. You even can do your own presentation. Like in my case, I also did a small YouTube video like this one. But in general, I think you're going to pass it definitely. It's not so difficult. So I'm going to give it like 1 out of 5 stars to this lecture. And the last one is like a key qualification. Like I said before, it's going to be English for IT. It was really easy. You don't need to be good in English speaking like myself a little bit. You don't need great grammar. The most important thing is that you do your homework in English, and you're gonna read somehow, I think, like a lot of scientific articles. You have to write your own opinion about this article. If you still have any questions about business information technology study here in Germany, then write any question you're gonna have. I'm gonna answer those questions, and yeah, I wish you a great day. We're gonna see this next video. Bye.